there is right, there is every if you sell quarterly by Copasi, then that was purely on credit. But if you want to get, you want to sell physical, that has to be monthly really. Physical has to be monthly. There's no other model. Maybe as other people would like to voice some opinion on it. I'll just, well, there's no question. I'll just move into, I think one of the questions was last, I was asked in one, a few of the sessions before, was how the credit, how the number of credit being awarded. I think just now, Mr. Alfred has shown that that's a vague example of how much credit that you can get. RSPO will award the credit on the first day of the year, on the first day that you get your certification. And that will depend on the production last year, okay? But that credit will be accounted for the duration of the certification. For example, if last year you make 100 ton, and this year you make 70 ton, so there will be a deficit of 30 ton. That means you cannot oversell it. You cannot sell this 30 ton that you don't have. They will award 100 ton for you. But at the end of the year, before the certification closed, you can only sell what you produce that year. If there's a deficit, you have to pay back. If there's a surplus, you can claim back. And let's say if you do 70 ton and you sold that 100 ton credit on the first day, that means you will have to cough up the 30 ton out back to the system. If you have 100 ton and you produce 120 ton, that means RSPO, then that means we will have to write to our auditor to ask for that the other 20 ton credit so you can sell it. But it has to be closed off. So every year when you close off, it has to be exactly what you produce. But the award of the credit is based on last year's production. So I hope this is clear. This was one of the questions being asked last. We'll probably start a queue, a frequent asked question on our Facebook page so people can go to and read it. I think that would be valuable. I see someone raising their hand. Lina, can you unmute that person? Gunalan. Feel free to ask any question. Even in Hakka also can. In Chinese also can. I will translate the question and then answer in English. No question.
Hello， 听到吗？
听到，可以问。
我听你们讲到这么多是，我只是明白就是讲，我应该是相信你们，跟你们去做，然后你们会照顾我们，然后其中里面很多细节，很多 detail 的东西，我觉得我很像也没有什么必要去了解更多，对不对？
如果我先。I will answer Mr. Law in Chinese, then I will rephrase that in English, if somebody don't understand. 对，你讲的，如果你是觉得你对我们有信心的话，其实在这个过程里面 ，RSPO 的过程里面，那个你不用担心， 那个是我们全部人已经有请人，一年花那么多钱的去请人，就是要帮你们做这种东西的。OK，那个细节我们来处理。现在就是讲解释这个东西，就是说要给你一个大概的一个明白，就是讲这个是什么东西，这个是有钱，这个是有钱的，我们不拿就是笨蛋了，我觉得啦是。所以如果你是相信我们的，你就加入来。如果你觉得某某一个时候你觉得是哎这个不适合我的话，你也可以退出。退出了之后，如果你觉得哎 OK 哦，我现在又觉得这个很 OK，你又可以再进来。这个东西是很 flexible 的，你也不需要去，你也不需要去了解太多，总之我们叫你去做。你觉得你做得到，你就做；你做不到，你讲出你的问题是什么，我们尽量找一个方式去，你又 OK 的，我们又 OK 的，去解决。如果真的是解决不到的话，你要退出，你那个也是 OK 吗？是不是？如果你是在猫跟 A 退出了之后，你至少拿了2年前的eligibility 吗？是，我觉得这个东西对小园主来讲是没有亏的，是没有亏的，So I just have a brief answer to that. So Mr. Lord is saying that he doesn't want to understand too much about RSPO, what's inside RSPO. He just want to put his faith into the corporacy and let us lead. We are more than happy to lead, and that is why we have hired so many people, training all these people, teaching them the knowledge to help you to get to RSPO. Okay, so don't worry about RSPO. Just worry about, do you want it? Are you going to engage it? Are you going to cooperate? If you're going to engage and you're going to cooperate, then we will get it. But if you think that halfway through, this is too hard for you, it's like I said to Mr. Low. If after 2 years, when you are milestone A, if you have problem, come to us, let us know what. We will tell you what to do. If you can do, you do it. If you cannot do it, tell us why, what is the reason? If we give you a solution, that solution for us will hope that you know it's something that you are comfortable with, it's something that we think that we can solve the RSPO requirement, then do it. But if you don't think so, don't do it. If you think that you want to drop out, you think that this is nothing, this is not something that I want to do, you can drop out at milestone A, you can drop out at milestone B. Or even at eligibility stage. And then when you feel comfortable or when you have the solution for it, you can come back in. Yeah? The flexibility is there. And the problem is, and another question is that if you drop out at milestone A, you already profited 2 years of eligibility. And I don't see any disadvantage in that. Is there more work? Definitely there will be more work because there's more money involved, so there will be more work. Is that easy? I think it's easier than planter, but smallholders, it's definitely easier than planter, but of course there are work involved. Okay. So I as long as you trust the team, we're constantly training the people, we're constantly talking to other people to have that knowledge. So as long as we have the faith from the smallholders, yes, I think everyone should join this and try it out. And there's a question is for the first batch participant to 2020, this is considered first year. We will do multiple batches as long as there is. I am thinking of doing batches in 50s. If we have more interest, let's say the first batch is 50, then the second batch can be 100 also. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter to the first batch. Or not. But once we go in, we will have to see. Let's say we have a 50 members that's joined. We have to see whether how good are these 50. We can even jump eligibility stage and straight away go for milestone A, or even straight away go to milestone B if all these people are ready. First year we can go to milestone B, or first year we It just depends how ready are the smallholders. We can even skip the first stage or the second stage. It doesn't matter. So if everybody are the top range, very well managed and all engaged and cooperated, then I think we can even go into milestone A or milestone B. Then we can get the certificate. But with that saying, you have to understand that second milestone A, you get more money than eligibility, and milestone B, you get more money than milestone A. So the earlier we go in with the higher stage, is more beneficial. We look for the maximization of the project. Anyone wants to voice out your opinion, you're more happy to listen. Anyone else who wants to say something? Then I think we'll call this meeting, this session off. I hope that that more people should come in and join and be interested, or even tell your friends about it that are in the corporacy. Even if they are not in the corporacy, they can join the corporacy and then join RSPO also. They don't have to sell to NYU. Corporacy is open to everybody. Just join the corporacy, be a member, and then we will take care of your MSPO, and then we also will help you engage in RSPO. So that's it. That's it from me. Anything from Mr. Alfred?
I'm good. I'm all right.
Any last words from you?
No, nothing. Just please join. What is the word? Bai na, bu na, hu ma. Is it come? Is it? It's almost a free, so-called free money kind of incentive for the corp. For the members to join. And like what Mr. Hugh said, eligibility stage is most of our members already there. And the money is there. When we cannot, then we drop. But why not we try and get the money first? And the intention is to help members for the corporation. And I think just now Mr. Law that saying that there is trust in the corporation. And of course, the team will do their best to solve the problems.
Yes. There are a few models also in terms of selling the credit as well. If we don't sell it through the share trading kind of platform, PalmTrace, if we don't sell it through there, we can also engage a company in, let's say, Johnson & Johnson, we can engage like a big company, Guailo company from Europe, America, that wants to help you guys and want to engage. We can go to them and say, hey, look, we have 300 smallholders engaged in RSPO, this amount of credit that we have. Will Johnson & Johnson willing to buy all our credit at a premium price? And all we need to do then, we'll have to make sure that the USD conversion is good, then it will be good. That will be the perfect scenario for Kabasi, is that we engage a Guailo company that is big enough that wants to support us. But before we go into that, I think I would rather to get somebody, a sizable number of smallholders in our maybe at least 150 or 200 smallholders that we have that in the corporacy that's interested in RSPO. Then I can go to them and say, hey, look, I've got these smallholders here. Would you like to support us? You know, we are doing RSP. 50 first batch, I think we just try it out first. There's a lot of model that we need to figure out, a lot of approval that we need to get from the members that are involved and also board of directors. But first of all, I mean, we've done a few sessions on RSPO already. The main problem for us now is to get that number of 50. So if you can try to help us to get that number to 50 and try to promote us a little bit, then maybe we can jump to the 50 faster, and then we can apply for RSPO faster, and then we can go to this eligibility stage faster. And once that we can show that to people that this money do coming in, then maybe there will be more people willing to join. That's how I see it.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. If there's no more question, then we'll end this session. I'm more than happy to take question anytime. If you're on our Facebook, you can ask there. If you want it to be private, you can ask Man. They will answer the question if they know. If they don't, they will come to me and I will provide the answer anyway. So there will be answers for you. Any doubts that you have, will be able to solve that. All right? Okay. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Hill.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye.